فائنلی یہ بات میں پوچھنا چاہتا ہوں آپ سے, آپ مجھے یہ بتائیں, فرانس میں مجھے کچھ عرصہ پہلے I met a person who became a murtad. He was a Muslim, an Arab. He became a non-Muslim. He became a murtad. He met me after a lecture and he used to go around debating people. He was influenced by many Orientalists and he's been reading the works of Goldziher. He's a famous Orientalist, a mustashrik. And he said to me, I have left Islam. I said, why have you left Islam? He said, the reason why I left Islam, he became a murtad, he became a non-Muslim. He said, the reason why I left Islam is because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that a group will remain in my ummah from the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam till the day of judgment. And he said, throughout my life, I have been studying the sciences of Sharia. I have been promoting the teachings of Islam. I have been teaching the aqidah of Islam. He's an Arab and he had a lot of knowledge of the sciences of Sharia also. He said, I became a murtad because this Islam is an impractical religion. It's an impractical religion. I said, why is it an impractical religion? He said that there has never been a true Muslim in the history of Islam. I said, what's your proof for that? He said, Ibn Taymiyyah, Qadi Shawkani. He mentioned all of these names. He said, these are the people of Haq, but they all believed in things which were bid'ah and shirk. So they were not true Muslims. Whereas the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that a group of people will remain in my ummah from the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam till the day of judgment. He said the belief that today the Salafiyya have, everything that they believe in, we do not find a single person who had all of that aqidah from their time till the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They may believe in some things that Ibn Taymiyyah believes in. They may believe in some things that Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani believes in. They may believe in something that Qadi Shawkani believes in. They may believe in something that Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali or Qazi or Ibn Hibban or Ibn Abdul Wahhab. But there you cannot find a single person in the history of Islam who has a sanad that the people, these people, whatever they claim today, everything that they believe in, we do not find that in the history of Islam. Therefore, I left Islam. He's a murtad now and he's preaching against Islam. I said, but what about the other groups in Islam? What about the Sufiya? What about the Qadiris, Naqshbandis, Chishtis, Sarwardis, the Shafi'is, the Malikis, Hanbalis, Ash'aris, Maturidis? He said, no. Don't talk about these people. These are deviants. Don't even think about them. I said, that is your problem. That is the problem. If you had studied with these people, then you would have seen this consistency. You would have seen this consistency. By Allah, I'm telling you, brothers, if you study with Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah, if you study with people of Tariqah, and this is the benefit of this turuq that we have today, I can say this to you. And you people, you just need to know this one hadith. One hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave this solution. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when you see ikhtilaf, when you see a lot of ikhtilaf, then you don't go back to Quran and Sunnah only. Not only Quran and Sunnah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inna ummati la tajtami wa la dalalatin, fa'iza ra'aytum ikhtilafan, fa'alaykum bis-sawadil a'zam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and this is in Ibn Majah, Sunan Ibn Majah, Kitabul Fitan. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when you see ikhtilaf, when everyone says Quran, Sunnah, they believe that Mawlid is a reprehensible innovation. What is the dalil? Quran. We say it's permissible, Quran. They give Quran, we give Quran. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave a solution. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when you see all of this ikhtilaf, this controversy, this conflict, everyone is giving Quran and Sunnah, and you can't make up your mind, then what is the solution? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِالسَّوَادِ الْعَظَمِ. Hold fast to the great majority of the ummah. This majority of the ummah will remain from the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam till the day of judgment. If you cannot make your mind up, then ask them for the sanad. This solution, I'm not saying this from myself. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said this. Ask them, present, prove your existence in the history of Islam. They will not be able to prove the existence from their time till the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They will give one or two names, but everything that they believe in today, they cannot prove one sanad going back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And by Allah, whatever I believe in today, whatever I believe in about the nur of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that is the aqeedah of Bayhaqiyya Waqt, of Waliyya Kamil, Sheikh Manzoor Ahmad Faizi rahimahullah. Whatever he believed in about the nur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is my aqeedah. Whatever he believed in about the knowledge of unseen of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that is what I believe in. Whatever he believed in about the tawassul of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that is my aqeedah. Whatever bayhaqiyya waqt, waliyya kamil, ghose zama, Hazrat Manzoor Ahmad Faizi rahimahullah, whatever was his aqeedah about the commemoration of the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that is my aqeedah. And you will not find a single difference between my creed and the creed of my murshid. And that is why I say to you, you people can give dalil. What is your dalil? Your tariqah is your dalil. If you are a Naqshbandi, present your shajra. If someone says to you, you present your existence, pull out your shajra. Say, here is my shajra. Here is my shajra of Qadiriyya. Here is my shajra of Naqshbandiyya. Here is my shajra of Sohrawardiyya, Chishtiyya, Shaziliyya, Rifaiyya. If you have a murshid, then you'll have no problems. You can present your shajra and say, look at this aqidah. Whatever I believe in, that is the belief of my murshid. And remember, whatever is the aqidah of my murshid, that is the aqidah of Shah Jamali Kareem. Whatever is the aqidah of Shah Jamali Kareem, that is the aqidah of Sheikh Abdul Rahman. Whatever is the aqidah of Sheikh Abdul Rahman, that is the aqidah of Sheikh Ubaidullah. Whatever is the aqidah of Sheikh Ubaidullah, that is the aqidah of Sheikh Khuda Bakhsh Khairpuri Rahimahullah. Whatever is the aqidah of Sheikh Khuda Bakhsh Khairpuri Rahimahullah, that is the belief of Hafiz Muhammad Jamal Awliya. Whatever is his aqidah, that is the aqidah of Khaja Nur Muhammad Muharibi Rahimahullah. Whatever is the aqidah of Khaja Nur Muhammad Muharibi Rahimahullah, that is the aqidah of Sheikh Fakhruddin, of Sheikh Kalimullah, and that is the aqidah of Sheikh Yahya Madani, and from Sheikh Yahya Madani all the way to Khaja Ibrahim bin Adham Rahimahullah, and then from Sheikh Yahya Madani to Chiraghe Dehlvi Rahimahullah. That is the aqidah of Sheikh Chiraghe Dehlvi Rahimahullah. Whatever is the aqidah of Sheikh Chiraghe Dehlvi Rahimahullah, that is the aqidah of Nizamuddin Awliya Mahbub Ilahi. Whatever Sheikh Nizamuddin Awliya Mahbub Ilahi believed in, by Allah, there is no difference between his creed and the creed of Baba Fariduddin Ganje Shakar Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Ali. Whatever Baba Fariduddin Ganje Shakar Rahimahullah believed in, that is the aqidah of Khaja Qutbuddin Bakhtiyar Oshi Kaki. Whatever Khaja Qutbuddin Bakhtiyar Oshi Kaki believed in, by Allah, that is the aqidah of Ata'ur Rasul Fil Hind Khaja Gharib Nawaz Ma'inuddin Chishti Ajmeri. Whatever Khaja Ma'inuddin Chishti Ajmeri believed in, by Allah, there is no doubt in this, that is the aqidah of Khaja Usmani Haruni. Whatever Khaja Usmani Haruni believed in, that is the belief of Haji Sharif Zandani Rahimahullah. And from Haji Sharif Zandani Rahimahullah all the way to Khaja Ibrahim bin Adham Al-Balahi Rahimahullah, that is his aqidah. And whatever he believed in, that is the aqidah of Fudail bin Ayaz Rahimahullah. Whatever Fudail bin Ayaz believed in, by Allah, that is the aqidah of Khaja Abdul Wahid Rahimahullah. Whatever Khaja Abdul Wahid believed in, that is the aqidah of Khaja Hasan Basri Rahimahullah. And whatever Khaja Hasan Basri Rahimahullah believed in, without any doubt, that is the aqidah of Babu Madinatil Ilmi, the door of the city of Ilm. And whatever is the aqidah of Mawla Ali Karramallahu Wajhul Kareem, that is the aqidah of Muhammadur Rasulullah.